And the next one is on November the 4th, Adlai Stevenson, which is your specialty. How often did he run, and who did he run against, and how badly was he beaten?
He ran twice in 1952 and 1956. He had the misfortune of running against a great military hero, Dwight Eisenhower. And so I don't really think that there's any way that Adlai Stevenson could have won those elections. Americans like military heroes. It's true there were a few generals that ran that did not win, but Eisenhower is an unassailable character, and I'm not sure that Adlai Stevenson ran the most efficient campaign, at least in 52. He handled the media poorly. He would still be giving these lovely speeches, and you would see at the bottom of the screen that this is a program that's supported by the Democratic National Committee. He never could change his rhetoric and sort of couch it in the necessity of television time.
He'd run out of time. I mean, he'd be cut off in the middle of the speech.
Yeah.
Because the speech, and people who were traveled with him were driven to distinction. He had great speechwriters too, by the way. Arthur Schlesinger Jr. and John Kenneth Galbraith. And,
John
I mean,
Percy,
there's a whole generation of people. Newt Minow. I mean, the people that Stevenson brought into the process. But
still, these were not. He lost what in the high 40s, and then the second time he was in the lower 40s.
Well, he managed
but
to lose.
But they weren't disasters.
No, but he managed to lose to a president during a recession. I mean,
that's
not easy to do. You're right about Ike. He was hard to beat.
But yeah. But what's really amazing, the real number that stands out about 52, is how much the electorate grew. Something like 11 million.
Yes,
voters
and that's
more than just 4 years before. And that's, in part, that's a reflection on the Dewey-Truman choice, but more, it's a positive reflection. People were given these two spectacular candidates to choose from.
I would like to play up on the independent. This is Adlai Stevenson's contribution to modern American
politics. All right, then I have another one, so
good. Okay.
Yeah.
It's cultivating this new group of independents. Now, we all know that they're, I don't know what the statistics are now.
Roughly a third.
Know, yeah. Are independent. They're not assigned to any, they don't choose any party. And it's Adlai Stevenson who begins in this sort of primitive campaign in Illinois to try to encourage independents to support someone who's an intelligent candidate.
Well, that's a perfect transition for me. His legacy is he's obviously an intellectual. Ike knows it. He beats him. So what's the moral? Well, the moral is the voters don't want an intellectual. So Eisenhower, as our friend Fred Greenstein proves years later, begins as president, dumbing down his speeches.
Did he have to?
But it was a side of
yeah, no,
smart.
No, going into
Eisenhower
that's my point. But also how he thought that. That Stevenson played. His lesson is people don't want the intellectual, and so he didn't want to sound like him, and so he would go in and cross out words that they'd written and make smaller words, and literally in his own hand. And the culmination of that is the great Saturday Night Live skit, because then you have a series of Republicans who campaign this way. To this day, they don't want to sound the intellectual, and it leads to that Saturday Night Live skit where Reagan's in the room sounding addled, and his aides leave. And then he's brilliant and knows throw weights and great details of policy in the privacy of his thing. So Stevenson's jokes about eggheads notwithstanding, both parties decide that's probably not the way to get elected.